play Hamlet. We were all coming on the train, and somehow some people got left behind, and so everyone's freaking out. And when it came time to actually go into the ticket area, something happened, and like we're all shuffling, and the violinist started playing like a super intense, like, and everyone, it was just so funny because everyone's freaking out, and I just think captured the moment really well.
I think my favorite memory of Miss Uskirt was probably, I think, the first day of school of my junior year, because I was really nervous, like, just going into a new house, and then just walking in, and she, like once the bell rang, she, like, sat everyone down. She's like, okay, you guys, like, I made coffee cake, but I wasn't sure if any of you guys, like, were allergic to nuts, so I made, like, one without nuts and one with nuts. I don't know, that's, like, my favorite, just because she's, like, so sweet.
When she mixes up my name with Evan every other day in advisory.
When we would always go on field trips and something would always go wrong with the transportation, how we missed the bus the first time, or when we went to the city and Miss Uskirt didn't get off the train at the right stop. Like, even though things went wrong, she would always find a way to turn it into a positive.
When I first came to Hillsdale, I like how nice she treated me and like how she introduced me to people and wanted me to succeed.
My favorite memory of Miss Uskirt is during Gov class when she made fun of me for sleeping in front of everyone, and it was super funny.
My favorite memory is when we were supposed to go on a bus to Half-Moon Bay and do a beach cleanup, and then like we were sitting at the bus stop, and then the bus just drove by, and Miss Uskirt was like, wait! And yeah,
and they left.
And then they left us, and we literally went to the mall.
My favorite memory was specifically when Miss Uskirt roasted Max and sent them into a deep state of depression.
My favorite memory with Miss Uskirt was when we were doing a discussion during class, and then I talked to her after the discussion and told her about me not feeling comfortable. So what she taught me that day was that if you don't speak up and let others know the truth, then how are they supposed to know and be more sympathetic? So you showed me that although I might be scared to share my opinion, it's very valuable so that other people understand and have more sympathy towards other people.
I have many favorite memories of Miss Uskirt, but one of my favorite memories was going to see PK for the day. Also, when I told Miss Uskirt that I was going to miss her in class and she didn't say it back, that's okay, but it's fine. Still love her.
My favorite memory would definitely be when she won that field trip for us in junior year, and she brought us on a topless bus to the Wax Museum in the San Francisco Dungeon. It was just a really fun experience.
My favorite experience would have to be when we stayed on the BART train too long with Devin, Gary, and I, and Ms. Uskirt, when we were supposed to go to the Tenderloin Center, and we had to walk an extra 10 minutes to catch up.
Great. My favorite memory with Ms. Uskirt is when there was like this one day where I was running late, and I got a phone call from you, and I was so worried that you're gonna bust me about being late. But yeah, I noticed that you called me to ask if I can cover for you because you were running late too. So I had to like lie and be like, oh, I have a stomach ache. And it was like the funniest thing ever.
My favorite memory was after senior defense coaching one day. I sat down, Ms. Uskirt, and we just talked about my issues for like an hour. And I think I got a lot of kind of knowledge from that experience. I've also had one of those conversations, and I thought it was really cool that like there could be like that level of conversation, but then like on the other hand, like you'll like roast me and stuff, and I really like that. I think it's cool.
I have that also balance. Enjoy that.
Yeah, that's neat.
Also like all the field trips and stuff, like going on a double decker bus on the highway. That's like
the most serene experience of my life.
And also like for like culinary club and stuff, just like going above and beyond to like help us get going
and like, helping organize like Food Friday,
bringing the fritters like multiple times. That's some good stuff right there.
She's just so friendly. Like she's like on a Monday morning when things are crazy, I walk in and she's just like, she greets me with a smile, says good morning, asks me how my weekend was. Just, I don't know, she like really cares about people.
And you can tell she's a teacher that actually genuinely cares about her students, her class, and like the well-being of her students. Even if you're not in her advisory, she's always super welcoming to kids who come into tutorial, and she just like makes you feel super comfortable.
I'm gonna miss all the little side notes she would say about her family or funny stories about her kids and her personal experiences and any funny government jokes she had.
And she smiled and when she talked about me, about my classes.
What I'm gonna miss most about your class is your silly jokes and the little tangents that we go on as a class and the side conversations that we have.
I feel like I'm gonna miss everything because she always worked so hard to make her class like super fun and upbeat, even if she wasn't in the best mood. And just her presence is just like a gift, and it's really nice to have her around. I think she always made class like really interesting and interactive, so we always stay engaged. And also just like having having her presence there was really great because she would always like be so energetic and so passionate about what she was teaching.
I want to thank you first for 2 years of ongoing support. I know that we weren't especially easy, and for a lot of us, junior year and even senior year were very difficult. So thank you for being there for us and for supporting us through everything. I appreciate that you were there for me and that I could count on your class to have some time to breathe within all the craziness that I went through and that everyone went through. I'm sad that my sister won't get to have you as a teacher and advisor, but she doesn't really deserve you anyway. And I wish you luck wherever you go, and I hope that your next group of students are half as good as we were. So thank you and good luck.
I would just like to thank like Miss Uskirt for like, I don't know, she's just kind of like the nicest person I've ever met in my entire life. She's probably the sweetest and like generally like cares about like everybody, like all her students and especially her advisors. I'm just really grateful that I had her as an advisor because I don't know like if I'd be able to like get through a lot of things. It's like it was nice to have that support, like always there for me all the time. I'm gonna miss like seeing her every day.
Okay, I would like to thank Ms. Uskirt for all the patience that she has for all of her advisees, because I know some of us aren't really the most workable. I really appreciate for all the work and effort that she put in with us, and I'll really miss her when we're gone and when she's gone. And I hope she has a good time at whatever middle school or high school she's teaching. They don't really recommend middle school because middle schoolers are terrible. But yeah.
I would like to thank her for checking in on me all the time and for being so sweet, caring for all her students, and just being so passionate about her work.
I thank her because she always helped me with my new classes and she's always with me.
I want to thank her for everything. It's been amazing being in her advisory for the last 2 years, and it's just it's very sad to leave.
Yeah, I want to just thank Mrs. Kirk for being like such a good person. And, like, just thank you for being there for all of us and caring so much about all of us.
Thank you so much for all you have done for Timba 2 and for all of our students. You will be a great
I want to thank her for being so kind and being like my second mom, and for really taking care of me for the past 2 years at Hillsdale. I'm definitely gonna miss her, I think the most out of any teacher here at Hillsdale.
I'd like to thank Ms. Uskirt for being there for not only for me, but for everyone in this house. She's so helpful, and I know I can count on her even after graduation, as well as many others. She's always been there for us, she always listens, and she's so understanding, and I'm really gonna miss you, Ms. Uskirt.
I'd like to thank her for just making advisory kind of like a home away from home. She's really like all of our moms, and I can't thank her enough for like making this environment so supportive and being so caring and like really wanting us to be the best that we can be.
So I would like to thank her for just loving me and always caring for me more than I love and care for myself sometimes. Okay. I want to thank her for making school enjoyable and giving me an idea of what I want to do and be like in my future. I want to thank her for her somewhat funny jokes and always trying to stay hip. Also want to thank her for having that little bit of sass. And lastly, I want to thank her for teaching me how to be extra confident in what I do and in who I am. Thank you for being so amazing all the time.
Hey, Ms. Uskirt, it's Claudia. Not your advisee, but you know.
I'm Jackie, I am your advisee.
I'm like your adopted advisee. Ms. Babette's cool or whatever, but thank you for being the greatest teacher here ever. You're an amazing person. You helped me get through everything. Thank you for the letters of recommendation. yeah, I hope the best for you and your family. Hope everything goes well. And,
Mrs. Skirt, we just wanted to say thank you for everything you've done for us and helping us figure out our lives.
Well, I just want to say thank you, Mrs. Skirt, because if it wasn't for your lecture, I really wouldn't know what career would I would want today, so thank you for your lecture.
What career do you want today?
I
want
to be a lawyer.
Oh, okay.
Love you, Mrs. Skirt.
I'm Mrs. Skirt. I'm Ronick. I'm in your third period class. Transferred out of Mr. Stewart's class. I transferred into your class. I'm really thankful I did, because you're the bomb. I love you.
What up, Mrs. Skirt? You already know, we driving out here. Little man grown up. It's been great having you as a teacher the past 2 years. And that's explicit music. I don't want you to listen to that. And I just want to say that I'm about to miss you hella, and we got to stay in contact so I can tell you about all my college shit. Alright? Peace!
So I told you I was going to cry! I'm starting to cry. I can feel it coming.
I can't!
Everyone's like... What was this? Happy
feature? Oh, you guys don't watch me. Please!
Okay, okay, wait.
Okay,
I'm gonna... Take 105.
Take 106. Take 107.
I can't talk. Alright, what's your favorite memory with Mrs. Skirt?
Favorite memory with Mrs. Skirt? There's a bunch of them. You've had six.
Yeah.
To the top, I ball no knife in and pop bottles in the clip.